A very good morning to all. We group of two, Premnaga Nalaki Ravichandran and Tanavasagan Nalaki Velavidam, are going to present case study 1, ethical hacking.
Okay, my name is Tanavasagan, metric number 1022. Now we would like to explain the issue. Based on the statement, among the issue obtained, over 3 billion password and email combination has been compiled to massive data dump. Record of storage at another network service. The second one, the list dump COMB is a collection of the data from the previous breach, including the password, various platforms such Netflix, Gmail, LinkedIn, and many more. The most of internet users who replicate password cross multiply site are particularly at risk. The information release has been in the public domain and circulating on the dark web. Okay, there are many type of hacker, such black hat hacker, white hat hacker, and gray hat hacker. So let's see who did the data breach. So black hat hacker. So what is black hat hacker? Black hat hacker can range from the experienced to higher skilled individual with the goal of spreading malware and stealing private data such login ingredients, as the financial and personal information. When they reach their objective and replay on them, the hack can neither steal, exploit, or kill device depend on their motivation. The type of attack used by black hat hacker. First, hash cracking, phishing attack, leaf dropping attack, and dictionary attack. Let's see what is those attacks. Hash cracking. A hash is designed to act as a one-way function, a mathematical operation that's easy to perform and other form of the encryption. Instead of allowing someone to decrypt that data with a specific key, as typical encryption function do, hash isn't designed to be decrypted. When you enter your password on a website, it simply performs the same hash again and check the result against the hash it creates of your password when you choose it. Verifying the password validity without having to store the sensitive password itself. Phishing attack. Phishing is a cyber attack that uses disguise email as a weapon. The goal is to trick the email recipient into believing that the message is something they want to need a request from their bank, for instance, or a note from someone in the company, and to click a link or download an attachment. Leaf dropping attack. And leaf dropping attack occur when an attack interprets, delete, or modify data that is transmitted between two devices. Leaf dropping is known as sniffing and snooping. Relies on unsecure network communication to access data in transit between devices. Leaf dropping typically occur when a user connects to the network in which traffic is not secure or encrypted and send sensitive business data to the collision. The data is transmitted across an open network, which gives an attacker opportunity to interpret it via various method. Okay, the last one. Dictionary attack. A dictionary attack is a method of breaking into a password protected computer or server by systematically entering every word in a dictionary as a password. A dictionary attack can be used in an attempt to find the key necessary to decrypt and encrypt message or document. Dictionary attack works because many computer users and business insist on using ordinary words as password.
about how to protect your password. Password is a main thing that we can get in any accounts to log in. So there are various ways to protect our password. One of them is create a strong password. Strong password make our password easy to find by hacker and make us really protect our account. Secondly, use two-factor authentication and alternative. Example, you have to use Face ID and password to get in your phone. That is one of the two authentication and alternative. So you can use your face, either your fingerprint to go in your account. Third, make sure all your account is up to date. Update is a main thing released by the developer to make the upcoming security update. So if you forget to update our software, it is a best way to hacker getting through. Next, stay know about recent password breach. So every account user used to be have to be alert in security breach. So security breach is a basic breach that used by our hacker to get into your account. So you have to alert of every security breach. Create strong password. So one of the ways is create strong password, avoid periodic password change. Frequent password change actually lead to weaker password, more likely create short or easy to guess password. If we change our password frequently, it will lead the hacker to get our account very easily. Because password change make our account really weak, then we do it frequently. But if as advice, we can change our password every couple of months. So it also a safe one. Secondly, remove arbitrary password compulsory requirement. So we have to put at least one lowercase or uppercase password, uppercase word or any symbols to make sure our password is safe. Because everyone will use dictionary password or guessing password. So if we use our account name or any simple name, they will be easy to guess. So if we use example Tana123 is a password that everybody can guess. But the exclamation mark is very difficult. So it's hard to keep by the guess by the hacker. Next, to use factor authentication and alternative. So as I mentioned before, two authentication still requires account to have username and password. But they are like two credit authentication. So we have to have password and fingerprint either Face ID. So we will use our primary email account and we have to use our biology fingerprint or iris face to grant the second access. So when you log into your account, the first thing the account security will ask is person biological fingerprint iris face to grant. It's only known as a biometrical security. So when we use biometric security, it's easy to get because our fingerprint, face and our iris are very specific and very unique to get by others. Nextly, make sure all your software is up to date. We have to install antivirus and anti-spyware software on all our devices and maintain consistent update and this tool. So mainly these tools are designed to avoid breach, password leaking, and our virus to get ourselves safe from virus. So if we forget to update any software tools that kind of antivirus or anti-spyware, we will get there are highly chance to get hacked by a hacker because antivirus and anti-spyware software is updating because the developer are making more security update to make their software secure. So if we forget to update it, our necessary if we never forget to update the software, the necessary patch that done by the upgrade will not get by our system. So our system defense will be so weak and easy to get by the hacker. We have to take the time explore your login security. Next, we have to know about recent password breach. Okay, there are various methods hacker are using to crack password, as you know, and receive sensitive information. The knowledge can help create stronger password credential and implement other ways to protect your information. So example, we know about one password breach. We can be secure and we will know that how they hack the system, then we can make sure that we are not making the same mistake. And staying up to date can keep your company protect. If a company or partner will experience a data breach, there's chance of your information could be compromised. So we have to make sure the company we are in have to protect and we are aware of security breach. Okay, let me go with the conclusion. So as a conclusion, I want to say, password fry the first line defense against unauthorized access. So we have to make sure our password is protect and very strong password. So we have to have a strong password for all your account, and mainly don't use same password to all your account. So it can be a better chance to get hacker to get our account. So we have to make sure our password is strong and never use a same password to all the account. And your computer protect your password. And we also will be safe from hacker and malicious software. So we have to make sure our password is strong and unable to predict by everyone. These are the ways to protect our password and account. So this is all from us. Thank you.